Hope my screen is visible, sir. Can you please confirm?
Yeah, it is visible.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you so much, everyone, for joining. And good morning to you all. And today we are having Ankush Agarwal, sir, with us for another Impact Salesforce Saturday session. He's a 3x Salesforce certified senior Salesforce developer at MHS Market. And he's also a group leader for the Salesforce developer group, Bhilwara India. And also, Ankush, sir, is one of the active person at the Trailblazer community. So thank you so much, Ankush, sir, for being for delivering a session with us, and thank you everyone for joining. So this is a brief introduction about me. My name is Harshit Sharma, and I'm a 3x CRM certified Salesforce trainee at UST. I'm a volunteer at New Delhi Salesforce developer group, and these are my social handles. In case you want to know more about Salesforce or you have any query, you can feel free to reach me out on these handles. So the New Delhi Salesforce developer group was started in Feb 2016, and these are the social handles where you can reach out to us. There is the website for the New Delhi group where you can reach out to us. Okay, so the Impact Salesforce Saturday session is a series of online Salesforce Saturday sessions, and where we deliver knowledge.
आधा रह गया है ना, आधे को आधा, और इसके अंदर पूरा डालेंगे, क्योंकि हद तक तो भी ऐसा हाइट से अपन खड़े रह के भी यूज कर समझो। ये देखो, ये इसके अंदर
कैन यू
इतना
प्लीज म्यूट
काटेंगे बोले तो ये फ्रेम में अपना पूरा काम हो।
यू सो या थैंक यू सो यू गाइस कैन फाइंड ऑल द पास्ट सेशंस एंड द अपकमिंग सेशंस इन द लिंक मेंशनड हियर. And Talent Central is an initiative taken under by the New Delhi Group. It is a concept similar to the Monster.com or Naukri.com. Here we help the students who are seeking to start their career in Salesforce ecosystem, or the people who are switching towards the Salesforce ecosystem to find the jobs. So recently we have been able to successfully place three aspirants with the help of the Talent Central as a trainee in the UST. So these are the success stories of the Talent Central portal. And this is another initiative taken under by the New Delhi group. Let's implement here. We groom the trailblazers in the community by sharing the knowledge, and later we help them to get the professional opportunity with the help of Talent Central. And Journey to Salesforce is a program taken under by the Salesforce Developer Team India, where they help people to migrate from other technologies towards Salesforce and pursue their career. So these are the top contributors for the New Delhi group who help us by sharing information about the coming sessions and help us to manage them well. Thank you so much to all. And these are the social channels where you can follow us for the session recordings, session presentations, and also for the past and upcoming session details. Also, recently we are coming up with a giveaway on the YouTube and Twitter, so please do check out that, and also please do follow our social handles. Thanks to our sponsor Cloud Vandana and Creopas for their immense support, and thank you once again all for joining. Thank you, Ankur sir, over to you please. Thank you.
Okay, thank you Harshit for the introduction. So I am Ankush Agarwal. First of all, let me share my screen.
Yes, so the screen is visible.
Okay, thanks for the confirmation. So today our topic is on Lightning Message Services. So today we'll talk about Lightning Message Service. What is Lightning Message Service? How it is used, and how we can utilize it with Lightning Web Components. And we have another two sessions on upcoming Saturdays on where we will talk about how it can be implemented with the Aura components, and then on the Visual Force component. Okay, so I'm a senior Salesforce developer at IHS Market. I usually contribute on Answers community whenever I get time. You can connect with me on LinkedIn, Twitter, or you can follow me on the Trailblazer. So today's agenda is first of all, what is Lightning Message Service, then how it works. So there will be a flow diagram. What is the scope of the message service? Then Lightning Message Channel is used to transmit the message from one component to another component. So what is Lightning Message Channel? Then we'll see the implementation of Lightning Message Service on LWC components. And we'll go with the demo, and at the end we'll take the questions if there is any. So first of all, what is Lightning Message Service? So basically it is used to communicate between Visual Force page, Lightning component, or Lightning web components. So on a particular app or on Lightning pages, let's suppose a company is moving from Classic to Lightning, and they were having like Visual Force pages or Lightning Aura components, and now they are moving to the Lightning web components. So on a Lightning page, there can be multiple different components, and right now in the current phase, we are just using Agile, so where we have short sprints, and in short sprints, like on a Lightning page, we have 10 components, and the project decide to just move only 4 components to Lightning web component, and in the further phases, they will just upgrade it. So in that case, what happens if you want to communicate between like Aura component, Lightning web component, or even on Visual Force page on same app or in the Lightning page, then we can use Lightning Message Service, where one of the component will publish the message or the data specific information onto message channel, and then another component can subscribe to that message channel, and that will just get updated based on the message. So it generally works upon the PubSub model. Or so currently there is an alternate for this, like platform events also can be used to communicate between different components, but it is used because it is specific to these components, and platform events basically used for like different type of applications, or if you want to send this that particular information outside Salesforce as well. So this Lightning Message Service specifically used with Visual Force page, Lightning component, and Lightning web components. So Lightning Message Channel is used. So Lightning Message Channel is used to communicate between different components. So next is the flow diagram, how it works. So for example, on a Lightning page, we can have Lightning web component, Lightning component, or Visual Force page. So what happens, for example, Lightning web component can publish some message or some data to Lightning message channel. And as and when it will publish, at the same time, whosoever subscribe to this message channel, whether it's a web component or Aura component or Visual Force page, they will just get the message on those components, and they will get updated automatically. So with the events in Lightning web components, we have limitation, like those can be interacted with the Lightning web components only. So message service is generally used between any of these three on a particular page or in an app. And we can restrict the scope for the subscription, like from where we can get the notifications or the message in the message channel. So the scope of the message service. So let's suppose this component is subscribing to a message channel. So So they can decide, means we can decide the scope. So there are two options. By default, whatever the active components on the particular page or particular app, those are all can send a message, and the subscribe component can get those messages. But if a component want to get the message from the application level, like there are hidden console tabs or subtabs or apps are there, so they can get the notifications from them as well. So for that, we need to define the scope as an application. So from a particular application component, get the notification from anywhere, means any of these components. So next is Lightning Message Channel. So to utilize Lightning Message Service, we have to create Lightning Message Channel. And this message channel is used to interact between the any of the component. And first of all, like this message channel can be referenced with the __C. So it is not a custom object, but it can be referred with __C. So first of all, we have to create a message channel in our org, and this message channel must be into message channels directory at this particular location in the VS Code. And the file name must end with .message channel meta.xml. So we'll see how we can create the message channel. So now we'll go for a live demo, like how we can create a message channel. So just before starting it, so what I have done, I have created a Lightning page where we'll see the demo of this Lightning message services. And there are two components. First component is showing us the list of the contacts, and the second component will show the contact details. So there is an option like we can click on show details. So right now it is not showing any details. So we'll use a message channel to transmit the detail of this particular report onto the another component, which is for contact details. So to do that, first of all, we have to create a message. First of all, we have to create one folder over here, which name is message channels. And inside this, we will create a new file, which name is like whatever name we want to provide to the channel. Like we'll be interacting for the contact details. So we can name it as contact message channel dot message channel and then meta dot xml. So this file has to be created, contact message channel dot message channel dash meta dot xml. So as we seen in the last slide, like the it should end with dot message channel dash meta dot xml. So this has to be the file names naming convention. It should end with this. So we have created this, and now we need to provide the details. So we'll just take it from this developer library. So here we have like Lightning message channel, and then master label is the name of like message channel. So for us, we are mentioning as contact message channel. So we'll be using this contact message channel to communicate between the different components. And it should be, it is having another attribute, which is export, is exposed. It should be true. And along with this, we can create some specific fields as well, like if you want to pass specific information. So Lightning message fields can be used. So we can define a specific fields like record ID or record data, or in our case, we can define like contact ID or other contact details if you want to pass it between the multiple components. So we can define Lightning message fields as well, but this is not mandatory to define the fields. So we will be just using this master label, which is the name of the message channel. And now we'll just deploy it to the org. So once it will get deployed, okay. Oh, let me try it again. There is some error on this.
If you are having a
okay, so yeah, now it is deployed. So here I have defined one field as well, which is like field name is contact ID, but it is not mandatory to define a field. So now we'll move to the next, which is like, as I explained, like we have a list of the contacts, and on the show details, we need to pass that particular specific records information to the contact detail page, where we can show the details of that particular contact. So we are taking, this is just for an example. You can take in real life scenario, you can take any other example where you need to communicate between two different components and you need to pass on some information. So we'll go to the, first of all, I have two LWC components. One is contact list and another is contact detail. So in contact list, we are displaying contact details. And to utilize publish, there are two methods which are majorly used, publish and subscribe. So first we have to import publish method and message context. So it is message context is used to pass the message to the message channel. And for this, the model is Lightning slash message service. So we'll use Lightning message service to get the methods publish and message context, and we'll utilize it to publish a message on the message channel. And just now we defined this contact message channel. So we'll also have to import this message channel. And we can name it anything. So for example, contact message channel, and we'll call it from @salesforce / message channel and its name. So we have provided its name as contact message channel. We'll just take it as it is. and underscore underscore C. So as I explained, we have to use underscore underscore C to define it. And inside this JavaScript file, we'll be referring this contact message channel as a reference. And one more thing, to utilize this message context, we have to use wire. So we'll be defining it message context, and we'll create a variable as message context. Okay, then next is like we have a table. Just a minute. So we have a table, Lightning data table over here, and on row action, we are calling a method handle row action. So we'll just go into this handle row action method. And here we have already defined, like, means we first we are fetching what action is clicked. So we are taking its name, action name, and we are checking whether it's delete or details. So for details, we need to pass on the contact ID. So contact ID we'll get from this row. So we are getting all the details of that particular row on which the event is fired. And here we will publish the message. So we'll just use a publish function, and we'll pass it is having three parameters, as you can see here. So first is message context, then message channel, which we named as contact MC. And then what is the message we need to pass? So for passing a message, first of all, we have to create a variable message, and it will be in a JSON format. And we can pass over here record ID, and the value should be row.id. So we are passing like row is like contact record, and its ID we are passing over here. And it will be stored in the record ID attribute of this message. And now we can just define all three parameters, which is first is this dot message context. The second one is this contact message channel. So the second would be contact MC, and then next the third parameter is the message, what we want to pass from here. So this way we can just publish the message onto message channel. And so first of all, we'll just deploy the changes to the org. Yeah, so changes are deployed. And now next is, so this way we can publish it. We'll test it once we'll mention the subscribe as well. So now we need to subscribe for message channel. So in the similar way, first of all, we have to import subscribe method and message context. Message context from Lightning message service. And also we have to import the message channel from where we will get the message or notification whenever any message will be published onto that particular channel. So again, contact MC will take the name, then from @salesforce/ message channel and its name. So we have used contact message channel __C. Okay, now to subscribe, what we have to do, we have to create one variable. So again, first of all, we have to wire this message context. So we'll define @wire message context and we'll create a variable message context. Okay, and we'll create one more variable, which is subscription, and we'll define it as null. So we'll hold the subscription details into this variable. And to subscribe, what we will do, we'll create one method, subscribe message channel. And here we will check. So here we will define like this dot subscription. And here we will use subscribe method, which we have defined on the top. So here we need to pass again three parameters. First is message context, then message channel, and third is the function which will get the value from the message channel. So this is the difference over here. Earlier we just passed the message. Since we will be getting the message as a parameter, so we'll be holding it into a function. So first of all, first parameter is message context, this dot message context. Then second is message channel name, which is contact MC. And third parameter is it will be a function. So this is arrow function we can define, and here we can store that message into a variable, which is called message. And since we have this record ID over here, so we'll update this record ID based on the message what we have received dot record ID. So while passing or while publishing, we have defined record ID as row dot ID. So the same thing we will use in our response, means in the subscription. So whenever we'll get any message, so we'll get that particular record ID into with the message dot record ID. And you can pass any other variable or any other details as well in the JSON format. And just using this dot, that attribute name, you can just receive that information. And we are just updating over here the record ID. So as and when we'll just update the record ID, we'll be able to see the details on the detail page. So that's all we have to do for subscription. But yeah, we have defined the method, but we need to call it in the connected callback. So whenever the component will get load, it will just call this method and it will check if there is any message channel or available, and it can subscribe to it. So whenever any publisher component will publish details on the message channel, it will just receive an update that similar at that time itself. And so one more thing we have to handle over here. So if the subscription is already means we'll just check for this subscription for the first time. If it is already subscribed, we'll just ignore it. So what we have to check this dot subscription is not equal to null, then we'll just return this dot subscription. So we need not to call this subscribe method every time, each and every time. We just have to subscribe once, and whenever the message will be populated into message channel, it will automatically reflect over here. So we can just skip this part each and every time. We just have to define only once, or we just have to perform the subscribe method only once. Okay, so now we'll just deploy it to the org. And we'll just try to test it on this LMS demo page. So just to verify, first we have to refresh it. And we'll try to see the show details. Okay, so it is not showing for now. Let me refresh it again. Okay, so we have to check and we have to inspect like what went wrong into this. So how we can analyze this? Generally it takes some time, so but we can check with the console log whether it is getting published successfully or not. So we can define here like message, and we can see if message is getting populated or not. And in the subscription part, we can check if we are getting this subscription over here or not. Subscribe message. So we'll deploy both the components. We'll refresh it. No action triggered. So somehow this is not getting called. Action triggered. Okay, it is coming over here. We'll check the name details. Okay, please check in for. Okay, so we'll see why this is not getting called over here. First of all, so the publish method is not getting called for now. So I think our changes are not reflected yet because it is not showing the message over here. Ideally, it should show this log as well. So I think it is not reflecting. So it takes generally some time to reflect the changes over there. We'll try to deploy one more time and see if it works. Or we can just try to edit it. So if this doesn't work, then generally we can do it on. Yeah, so now this row action and message object and subscribe message. So now it is working, means the message is getting updated. We have to see what type of message is coming in the. So we can use json.stringify to see the details of this message, what message is coming over here. So it is publishing, but it is not showing the details. So again, I think we have to edit the page, or we can use the incognito mode. So there, because generally what happens, it just picks the old image of the Lightning Web component. So it doesn't show the correct value. Okay, so here it is coming record ID. So still it is correct. Now we need to check record ID. We are using the correct record ID over here. And now we need to see over here record ID. We are passing the record ID over here. Okay, yeah. We have just missed one part, record not null. So we have defined one variable over here. So we are checking if record not null, then only we'll be loading the form. So we have missed this part and we have to just update here this dot record not null as true. And we can just deploy the changes again. And we have to refresh it. I think we have to go back, edit the page. And because in this Lightning Web component, it doesn't show the changes immediately. It may take the old version of, yeah. So now we can see the contact details over here. So if I click on any of the record, so like for Andy Young, I'm just clicking on show details and it will show me details of Andy Young, like its email, date of birth and lead source. So I can click on any of this record and I can see the details now. So what happens on the back end, it just subscribe only once, as we have mentioned in this JavaScript file, that just subscribe once. And if it is already subscribed, then we'll just retaining the subscription. So we are just subscribing only once, but whenever I will click on this show details, it will pass the record ID of that particular record and this component, LWC component get updated automatically. So we need not to handle it every time. We just have to subscribe once and we'll just get the update whenever any new message is published on the message channel. So this way you can just implement it in any other scenarios or any other problem where you need to interact between two components. And generally the events, Lightning Web component events are used where like components are parent child or there is some relation in the components. But there are a lot of scenario in real life where we have two different components. Both are not interlinked. Still, we need to pass some information to the other. So Lightning message services can be used in such scenarios, and we can just pass on the information to the another component and it just get refreshed on that same time itself. So that's all I have for today. And in the next session, we'll try to implement similar type of requirement for Aura components. And then next we'll go with the Visual Force component. And at the end, we'll also see how those three means we'll just put all the components on a single Lightning page. And we'll see like if I'm publishing something from a particular Lightning Web component, it is reflecting on the other components which are like Aura or Visual Force page. So it will get updated on all type of components, whether it's Lightning Web component or Aura component or Visual Force page. So mostly where the migration is going on, like companies are moving from classic to the Lightning Web component. So in such scenarios, we can utilize it and we can just communicate between different type of components. So yeah, that's all from my side. So if there is any questions or anything, yeah, we can discuss those.
Thank you so much, Ankur sir. There are some questions in the chat, so if you can please address. And also, once they are done, like I would just try to like give the participants the chance to unmute themselves and ask the question. So once the questions from the chat are done, we can take as them as well. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Please.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. So is it mandatory to have master label to be same as prefix of this? Yes, I think it is not mandatory, but yeah, for good, for our reference, it is good practice to have both the things same. But yeah, it is not mandatory. And then variable name is message channel. So is it a message context, Rahul?
I was asking regarding the field defined inside the channel, right? So
so this is generally what we can do is we can define specific fields, and we can restrict like all our publishers or subscribers that we'll be using that particular fields only. So we can define a specific message fields that we'll be using, but yeah, means it is not mandatory to define. So right now, as you can see, we have used record ID. So we can pass on any type of message in a JSON format, but just to practice a standard format, like, so in future, let's suppose someone want to subscribe to this message channel. And in real life scenario, what happens, like you have a message channel, it is defined last year, someone defined it, and it is publishing some component is publishing something. So what we can do to standardize everything, we can define fields over here, and we'll force everybody to follow the same, like the message must, instead of record ID, it should be contact ID. So the other person who in the future, like someone want to subscribe to this message channel, that person will be aware, okay, I'll be getting contact ID from this, or I'll be getting some other information from this. So likewise, we can just standardize this, but it is not mandatory. We can define fields without this Lightning message field as well. So it is just for making the code cleaner and best practice, just to follow the best practices. Okay. Yeah, so this was an issue. Yeah. Now maybe messages and defined inside message channel. Yeah, means we can do this, but yeah, it is not mandatory every time. Check if it's okay. Yeah, so I think recording will be shared by Harshit. So message context is to define, like means it's a predefined method, and it is just to pass the messages between like publisher and subscriber. So yeah, so Aman, I haven't tried this Blowable Club, so I cannot assure you, but yeah, I'll just try and get back to you in the next session, where I'll see in between, I'll see whether we can pass this or not. Okay, and the name will be same as the object field name. Yeah, we can pass the exact field name as well. Means there is no such restriction in passing publishing anything. So yeah, you just have to follow this like in this format, and you can pass anything, whether it's object field name or anything else. Yeah, any other questions or anything?
Thank you so much, Ankush sir, for addressing the questions. What we can do, I can just share the code, and in the meantime, sure. If anyone has any doubt or still want to clarify anything, please feel free to post the question in the chat, so we can take that as well.
Sure.
So yeah. I can just share. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so this is the game pin, and you can log in into it using the link mentioned here, www.kahoot.it. And I'm just adding this in the chat as well, the game pin. So please do join this. Yeah, and please would request you all to keep an eligible name so we can just identify the winner easily. Yeah, and in the meantime, also, if you have any query left, please do post in the chat. Ankush sir can address that as well till the time we wait for the participants to join the Kahoot. Okay, we have a good number of participants already there. Maybe we can wait for a minute and then start. If anyone still left, please do join as soon as possible. We will be starting in a minute. Okay, so we can just start the quiz. Okay, so the first question is, components can interact with each other through, and the options are Lightning Message, Lightning Message Channel, Lightning Web Components, and Lightning Channel. Okay, almost everyone has already answered it. Okay, so the right answer is Lightning Message Channel. Okay. Our next question, Lightning Message Service can be used with, the options are Lightning Web Components, Aura Components, usual force pages, or all of this. So if someone has already heard Ankush sir, they can answer yep. Okay, so we can use them with all of this. Okay. The next question, which directory is required in SFTX project to create message channel? Okay, so right answer is message channels. Okay, Varun is still leading the school board. Which is the correct format for Lightning Message Channel file name? This was also explained by Ankush sir in the very beginning of the session. Okay, yep. So the answer is option number B. Okay, Varun is still leading this scoreboard. Last question for the day. Which module needs to import in Compound's JavaScript file to publish or subscribe with Lightning Message Service? Okay, almost everyone has answered the question. Answer is Lightning Slash Message Service. And we can see the leaderboard now. Okay, Gautam is on the third place. Congratulations, Gautam. Varun is on the second place. Okay. So there is some change in the leaderboard on the last question. Okay, Vishal is the winner. Congratulations, Vishal. And Vishal, I would request you to please share your email ID in the chat. Yeah, Vishal, if you can please drop your email ID. And also, if someone has any doubt or they want to discuss anything, please feel free to unmute and ask your question to Ankush sir. We can later wind up the session.
So Ankush sir, I have one question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like LMS is the latest one comparison to like PubSub model, right?
Yeah, right.
Okay.
So it is introduced, I think, before 2 years around. And so, yeah, means this is basically specifically for Lightning web components, Aura components. So specifically for this, like PubSub, we can use it, but still it is more faster and more advanced. So generally it is recommended to use Lightning Message Services where we just need to pass the information between the components on a Lightning page or in an app.
Yeah, so I mean like the independent component, not like as a dependent component, right?
Yeah, dependent component, we can use the events as well, or even in dependent component, you can use it. But generally we have LWC events or the component event in the Aura. So it depends, you can use it anywhere between the components, whether it is dependent or independent. But
both
components. Mostly, both type of component it can be used. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
So I'm just sharing two links for you. So first one I just shared, which is for Lightning Message Channel. So you can get all the details related to Lightning Message Channel. And another one is related to like how we can publish or subscribe in web components. So in next session, we'll talk about Aura components, how we can utilize it in Aura. And then we'll see in the Aura how we can do it. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Ankush sir, for being an awesome speaker. Yeah. Please continue, sir.
Yeah. So I just want to thank everyone to join today's session and listening to me and just holding with me while there were some errors in implementing it. But yeah, so thanks a lot for all of your patience and your time.
Thank you so much for being an awesome speaker, sir. And thank you all. And just a quick reminder to all, Ankush sir will be there with us for the coming Impact Salesforce Saturday session as well. And the session will be with respect to Lightning Message Service only, but this time with the Aura components. So please do RSVP and stay tuned for further updates. Yep. Thank you so much, all. Thank you. Have a nice weekend.
Yeah, thanks all. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Yep, thank you.